Welcome behind the scenes of our latest shoot, Newfangled Pinup. Hey guys, welcome to Phlearn. My name is Aaron Nace. You can find me on Twitter at AKNacer. Today, we're taking a look behind the scenes of our latest shoot, Newfangled Pinup. So we wanted to do a pinup shoot, but we wanted to take a little bit of a different approach than most people. We wanted to make it more than just, you know, a pretty girl standing somewhere doing something cool. And what we found is it took quite a bit of research into the pinups. Now, the original idea with the pinup was, you know, someone was gonna be, like a girl's gonna be mowing the lawn, and maybe a breeze catches her skirt, and you can kind of see a little bit of her underwear. She's like, whoops, that happened. So kind of like a peep. And what we found is, you know, a lot of these pinups are used kind of like with older pieces of technology, things from the 40s, 50s, and 60s. And it was really interesting to see that all these pieces of older technology had now become either almost obsolete or kind of brought together back into one piece of technology where, you know, at one time you needed a whole room full of, like, you know, giant computers and things like that. Now you have it all in your smartphone. So we decided to create an interesting play between the older technology and the new technology that replaces it. Not only a direct translation, but the fact that one piece of technology now replaces multiple different pieces of technology from the past. So we had our concept, and now we had to go about deciding how we were gonna pull it off. We knew we were probably gonna be including an iPhone in every one of these images, but we needed something to translate back to what these items used to be. Things like the internet used to basically just be a set of encyclopedias where you could look up information. The maps feature on your phone used to be just like a globe or an actual map. We have things like the typewriter, where, you know, that's how you used to send letters to your friends, and now you just have the same thing on your phone as well. So all these kind of older pieces of technology are now brought together in this new device. Here's a tip for you guys. If you're looking for something crazy like a prop or, you know, an old giant radio, obviously we don't have that stuff at the studio, but a great place to look is antique stores. Generally they're run by like really nice people, and if they're offering something for sale, let's say this antique radio, I think it was $1,000, oftentimes they'll let you rent things for like 5, 10, 15% of that price. And if you're really cool, you can even talk them down a little bit. In this case, we even got them to deliver everything to the studio the day of the shoot because they're kind of used to hauling things around. They have vans and trucks and things like that. So we were able to rent all these things from a regular antique store. They brought them all here for the day of the shoot. Once we were done, they took them all away, and it worked out very, very well. The lighting for a pinup shot is key. You don't want too deep shadows, but you do want to keep your lighting relatively interesting. You want to keep it much away from flat as you can. So we used 4 lights in this lighting setup to kind of sculpt our subjects. So the first light, and probably the most important light of this shoot, is the hair light, placed either directly above your subject or above and behind your subject. And this is something that I feel a lot of photographers miss when they're building lighting. For me, like the first couple of years that I was doing lighting in studios and things like that, I never added a hair light, and it became a really important part of lighting setup, especially when you're trying to do something that's gonna call a lot of attention to like facial features and hair and things like that, because it's gonna cast a really nice highlight on someone's face. Now, we used a large boom and light stand, but if you guys don't have one, it's not a big deal. If you have light stands and like a backdrop stand, like the horizontal bar that holds the backdrop, you can just use like a super clamp and kind of like, you know, put your light stands up behind your subject and then clamp a light up there behind them as well. So it's a really good way to get that hair light going, and I think if you guys start playing around with it, you really see how important they can become. The next 2 lights are rim lights. We had an 86-inch parabolic camera right, and that's gonna be behind our subject. That creates a nice highlight on the right side of our subject. And then the next light is a medium-sized softbox. That's the camera left, also behind our subject, and that's creating a highlight. It's a little bit smaller of a highlight, so it gives a little bit more of a kick. The fourth light we used is a fill light, also very, very important. With a pinup shot, you really don't want your shadows to be like too harsh and deep. So you want to put a nice big broad fill right up in front of your subject if you can. If you can't put it in front of your subject, fire it into the ceiling, it'll kind of bounce around everywhere. So we used an 86-inch parabolic right in front of our subject to the camera right. So when you guys are coming up with a concept for a shoot, keep in mind there are usually several different things that are going to make up if that concept either works or does not work. Now, with a pinup shoot, it might be relatively obvious, but there are some things that really need to be in place. Things like hair. The hairstyles that you're using in a pinup shoot are not the same hairstyles that people are gonna come to the shoot with, so you wanna be sure you get a really good hairstylist. Makeup is the same thing. We have quote-unquote pinup style makeup, so the hair and the makeup are really important. The props are also really important because they're the things that kind of sell the idea that these are a little bit older. And the last thing is the wardrobe styling, which again, needs to kind of be from the era in which you're supposed to be recreating. So all these four things are really important. And without any of those, if you did like, you know, great props, great makeup, great wardrobe, but you didn't have the hair just kind of looked like, well, my hair, it would all fall apart. So keep in mind those things are really important when you're designing a shoot like this. Also take advantage of any cool opportunities or props you might find along the way. We found a really cool Coke container that had nothing to do with our concept, but we really wanted to shoot it, and it also became one of our favorite images out of the photo shoot. So it doesn't fit with our original series, however, it does stand alone on its own. So we kind of got a series and a standalone image out of the same shoot. Now, bringing it all together in post-production is one of the most important parts of the series. It's supposed to be a pinup series, and that's where all the really cool stylization comes into play. With any pinup shot, you're gonna be talking about a lot of dodging and burning, and that's a real key in creating these amazing looks. Also, we did some really custom work creating and photographing our own textures that we then used on top of all of these images. So not only do they have that kind of like new age feel with the dodging and burning, but they also have that old age feel with the low contrast and the textures applied to them. Now, editing images in a series is a lot different from just editing a standalone image. Not only does the image have to stand on its own, but it's also gonna fit with the series. So what I do is I usually edit my first image, and then I'll go through and edit my second image with my first image up, kind of like looking at it and seeing how can I make it similar to the first, and do that over and over and over again. Now, you're gonna wind up at the end with a couple outliers, images that really aren't gonna look like the other images in the series. So after each image is edited individually, then the entire series has to go back and get re-edited to make sure they all look like one another. Not only just the look and feel, but we also made sure to crop them by the same aspect ratio, so they really do come together as a series. Guys, thanks so much for watching our behind the scenes look at how we pulled off a unique concept to a pinup shoot. Look for a Phlearn Pro tutorial coming soon. Thanks again, guys, and I'll Phlearn you later. Bye, everyone.